While it might be a popular, or perhaps stereotype, or a misconception, they say it's not a common practice for Austrians, or people from any other country, to regularly bathe in beer. Such practices are more often associated with cultural events, festivals, or wellness experiences that are created for novelty or entertainment purposes, rather than for any proven health benefits. Nevertheless, it sounds a great way to pass the time relaxing, and Nick and Daniels believe this is a load of rubbish, as they recently watched the Boozey Traveler, Jack Maxwell, a bartender from Boston, on the TV last night, and he did it as well as drinking alcohol from pine cones amongst the beautiful scenery whilst visiting Austria. Surely if the Austrians for sure make alcohol from pine cones, well, are as sure we believe they bathe in beer. In Scotland, we are known to bathe in whiskey, as well as drinking it. Some like it with a little hot water and a clove, some with some ice cubes, or the proper way to drink just the way it is neat. Anyway, it is on the TV, it must be true, right? In some places, there have been events or spas that offer beer baths as a unique experience. These baths typically involve bathing in a mixture of beer, water, and other ingredients. However, it's crucial to recognize that any perceived benefits are often anecdotal, and the scientific evidence supporting the idea that bathing in beer has significant health advantages is limited. But we do know drinking it is good for you, so why not bathe in it? Bathing in beer is not necessarily beneficial for your health, and it is not a common or recommended practice. While beer does contain some ingredients that may have skincare benefits, such as B vitamins and certain antioxidants from the hops and malt, there is limited scientific evidence to support the idea that bathing in beer provides significant health advantages. Nick and Daniels believe, well, the scientists are not that clever, are they? How can bathing in beer and drinking beer not have any advantages, especially when served by beautiful Austrian women in traditional Austrian dress wear? Moreover, beer is an alcoholic beverage, and soaking in it could lead to skin dehydration. The alcohol content in beer may strip the skin of its natural oils, leading to dryness and irritation. As for skincare, we are sure it will yield nothing that a bottle of Johnson's baby oil can't fix and hydrate the skin. Additionally, they say beer contains carbohydrates and sugars that, when left on the skin, could potentially attract bacteria and cause issues, particularly for individuals with sensitive skin or certain skin conditions. We always believed and told by our physical trainers at the gym that carbohydrates and sugars are good for you, are they not? Especially for revitalizing your body and giving you energy. Another good point to this fact is, how often do people drink alcohol from a glass whilst relaxing in the bath? What happens if you run out and fancy another glass of beer? Do you get out the bath and go to the refrigerator? No, you can just slide down in the bath and slurp away until your heart is content. This is why when our camper trailer made out of pallet wood is finished, Daniels and Nick will be adding Austria to their travel vlog bucket list. It's essential to note that if you have allergies, sensitivities, or any skin conditions, bathing in beer or any unusual substances may exacerbate these issues. If you are interested in skincare or relaxation, it's generally better to use established products with proven benefits and consult with a dermatologist or a healthcare professional for personalized advice. Always be cautious when considering unconventional health or beauty practices, especially if you drink too much beer and become too drunk and fall asleep in the bath. Ensure at all times to wear a life jacket with a snorkel and mask to keep on the side of caution. And it's advisable to rely on scientifically validated methods for promoting skin health and overall well-being. Nick and Daniels said, well, it cannot be any worse than us fiberglassing the camper trailer we are building, can it? Look what that does to our sensitive skin. Thank you for watching.